The first step in my drawing process always is a rough sketch, and I like to create those on a separate layer, so I go down here to the layers palette and create a new layer for my rough sketch. And now I will start to just fool around a little bit here. What I know is that I want to create a character. And I also want to create a character in a space theme. And the first thing that I'm doing here is I'm experimenting with some basic head shapes first. This also helps me to warm up a little bit. Just creating some organic forms. And when I find something that I think could start to look like something that I want to do, I just doodle around a little bit. This is actually the most fun part of any illustration project, because you are very free in your decisions. You can really just fool around a little bit and test some weird ideas. So I have a nice feeling with this character here. A very broad face, broad nose. This looks kind of interesting. And now I'm experimenting with one of these caps that they often wear under astronaut helmets. So together with this round collar here, that's probably the connection to the astronaut helmet. This looks pretty spacey. Some eyebrows suggested here. And it's very important in a rough sketch to not get too specific too soon, because what I am sketching here, it can be seen as the eyebrows, very large eyebrows with a small eye. It could also be a big eye. This is really something that your intuition will tell you at some point what you've actually drawn here. A technique that I also like to use is to use a selection tool, make a quick duplication by clicking and holding Control and Alt, and on the Mac that would be Command and Alt, and just pulling over a second version of my drawing, Control D or Command D on the Mac to deselect. Now I can perhaps use the eraser to erase some features and just make an alternate version. All the other elements that I had remain in place, and I can quickly experiment with these other elements. Some more lines here to complement the design. Let's zoom out a little bit to see what we have so far. Now is the time to decide which direction I like more. I think I like this direction more. So I will once again duplicate it, Control-Alt or Command-Alt on the Mac, and then just pull it anywhere you feel comfortable, release it. I zoom in again, and I will just work out some of these features a bit more. I'm seeing a big mustache here. This develops into an interesting direction, a very flat chin. I want the character to look a little bit cartoony. And I think we're coming close here to a point where I can say, okay, this is a rough sketch. This gives me a lot of direction for my drawing. So let's just work with this. So this is our rough sketch. This is going to be the base for our digital drawing. Let's zoom out a little bit to see how our digital canvas looks. So our sketches here are pretty small, and also we don't need the top row of sketches here. So first thing, I'm going to use the lasso tool to select this sketch here, and then there's a handy keyboard shortcut, Control-Shift-J, Command-Shift-J on the Mac. This will cut out our sketch and put it on its own layer. We can now simply make the other sketches invisible and can concentrate on our sketch here. Now let's position this a little bit better, and also let's scale it up. Edit, Free Transform gives us the transform handles. Now I'm just pulling these handles here to bring our rough sketch to a good scale compared to the total size of our digital canvas. Some rotation maybe even, why not? Enter for confirmation. And now we want to create our finished drawing on its separate layer. So let's create a new layer. And one way to do it now would be to turn down the opacity of our rough sketch and then sketch above it. But especially with characters, I actually prefer another method. What I like to do is to go to Image, Adjustments, Hue Saturation. And now I click the little Colorize checkbox here. And I ramp up the lightness of the sketch and the saturation. And I also adjust the hue so that we get a very bright yellow color here on our rough sketch. Okay, now I switch to our new layer. And now let's zoom in a little bit. And this way, my rough sketch is visually separated from my drawing. I do not confuse the rough sketch with my final drawing. And this might be desirable. In other cases, you might find that it's actually helpful if the rough sketch underlies your drawing in the same color. But in this case, I just wanted to show you that there's a variation of that, which might also work very well for you, depending on your personal preferences. And now I'm using the rough sketch as a scaffolding, so to say, to design the shapes and lines of my character. And I actually have an idea here to deviate from my rough sketch, because I'd like to give this spaceman here a little bit of character. So he's going to have an eye patch. Something like this, which lets him look a little bit like a pirate. And I think that's cool. And being a space pirate, he could have a cool star on his eye patch, something like this. Now let's refine a little bit. And now the task is actually to just go over the whole figure and add these little details. And now we fast forwarded quite a bit, and I have created lines here for all the elements of our drawing, and I'm just in the process of adding some finer details here around the eyes, around the nose area. And this way we have now covered our whole drawing with the first layer of lines. So we have a first layer of lines here in our drawing, but if we turn off the rough sketch in the background, we will see that our drawing looks a little bit flat and the lines all have the same quality, and we can bring much more character into our drawing if we now refine the line weight of our drawing. So the line weight, that means the width of the lines at specific points. And here you can see me drawing along the silhouette, the edge of the nose, and adding some more weight to the lines here, especially where they create a tangible edge, something that you could really feel if you ran your finger around it. Same is true here for the tip of the nose. And the rule here basically is that if something, a form, an edge, sticks out, you want to give it some extra weight. And also, if something is clearly in front of something else, you want to give it some extra line weight, like the mustache here, that is definitely in front of everything that's behind it. So let's give it some extra line weight. And this is a fun process, and you should actually invest a little bit of time in it, because it will really bring your drawing to the next level. Figuring out the anatomy of your character is one thing, but making sure that the line drawing itself as an abstract artwork looks nice is another very important step that you should not take lightly. Fast forward again. Now I have worked over my whole drawing, refining the line weight. And you can also use this pass for adding some hints of drop shadows here. So I did this in several spots, especially around the cap here, where it might just cast a little drop shadow on the face, and also here with the strap. I'm doing this now, indicating some drop shadows, and here something like a little drop shadow will do the trick to show the little seam here running around the whole cap and showing that it has volume, that it is a round seam. And if I zoom out a little bit, you can see that I've also created some shadow areas here where I don't expect any light to reach our drawing. If I now zoom out, you can see that we have a pretty nice drawing here with a nice line weight. We have some thinner lines that indicate interior forms and little wrinkles here. They shouldn't be too thick, because that would make them appear very heavy. And then we have the thicker lines around the tangible edges of our form. And we have also a thick line running around the whole figure, just to set it apart from the background.